God bless you. Briefly, I want to present us to the throne of grace. Briefly, I want to connect us to the realm of the spirit. There are depths and dimensions. There are spiritual economies. There are depths we cannot fathom. There are secrets we cannot access, except by divine revelations, by the power of the Holy Ghost. I want to briefly present a message to you titled, Not Me Again. Not Me Again. Before we take that sound, can you lift up your hands to heavens and pray for your family and pray for your loved ones? Decide your life. Decide your destiny, that you are not going to enter into a problem recycling again. Somebody can be moving in a cycle, but it doesn't mean you are making a progress. Moving in a cycle leaves you at a point. You are going a cycle to meet at the same point again. Every now and then, you are the same person. You think you are making a progress just because you are moving in a cycle. Until you move on a line, you cannot reach your destination. Take that prayer. Not you again. Not me again. Not me again. Let me present a woman to you called Naomi. Bible said there was a man called Elimelech. He had a wife called Naomi. They live in Bethlehem, Judah. But because of prevalent economic conditions of the land, they sojourned in the land of Moab. Naomi 1, Elimelech 2, Melion and Chilion, there are four that came into the land of Moab. When they came into that land, Bible says Naomi lost the husband, and people came on condolence. They said, sorry, God brought, God took. And it was a RIP everywhere. Call to glory. Transition to glory. After a time, another person died in the family called Malion. And people came and said, you again, Naomi. You lost your husband not a few months ago. Now you lose somebody else. They say, you again. After a while again, Naomi lost the remaining son. And they came and said, you again. This woman again. And they say, she's a woman of sorrow. And because of the compilation accumulation of condolences, Naomi changed her name from Naomi to Mara. She again. Every now and then she runs into a trouble. You again, people say. You again. When they want to narrate her story, say that woman that lost her husband, that woman that lost her first son, that woman that lost her second son, that plumpy woman turned slim woman. You again. Hey, not you again. In the book of Mark chapter number 7, Bible portray a woman that lost the husband, and they came and said, you lost a husband. And Bible said one of the husband's brother came and married her, and that one died. And people say, this family again. Another man rose up and married her and died. And people say, you again. Another one came up and married her and died. Until seven continents we are close, seven brothers we are close. People say, this family again. I come this day by the power of the Holy Ghost upon the prophetic office I occupy, and I look to you and say, not you again, not you again. That evil will not happen to you again. When something evil happened to you, and it happened repeatedly, people will now give you a name. You become a name of that nomenclature. They call you a woman of the issue of blood, not a woman of positive attitude, but because of the evil that are preoccupied in your life. But I decide your faith this day. By the oil of God upon my head, I declare, not you on evil sin again. Not you on evil sin again. Not you on evil sin again. They will not say that man again that had as the last year. Now another fertile isn't again. No, not you again. That woman had miscarriage last time. She again, not you again. Not you on evil things again. But you on favor again. You upon the eagle swing again. I see you on grace again. Not disgrace anymore. I see you on the eagle's wing, not on accident again. I see you on testimony line, not on evil things again. I see your marriage and wedding, not on divorce again. I see you carrying capacity, not miscarriage. I decree and declare, you on favor, not disfavor. You on promotion, not demotion. New acceleration upon your life, upon your life, upon your life.